In this video, let's explore some of the different groove alignment options that we have available when working with RePitch 2 Standard. All right, so let's dive in. So in RePitch 2 Standard, we have this new attack mode, and this gives us the ability to work with SmartAttack points. Now, essentially what SmartAttack means is that we have the ability to quantize our performance. We can quantize this to a bar beat boundary in terms of a grid, or we can quantize it to other tracks. Now, one of the unique workflows that we have the ability to do is that we can extract the groove from things like loops or percussive segments or anything where you have a strong indication of what's happening with the bar beats. This can be useful for tightening up vocal performances. So what I'm going to do in this video is let's explore the different ways in which we can work. All right, so really quickly, let's take a lay of the land over here. I've got a lead vocal, and then I've got four different vocal harmonies. We also have our instrumental, and then I've extracted a drum stem from this instrumental. So temporarily, let's just take a listen to the lead vocal playing against the drum stem.
Better in the dark time, the sense is up. Lights off, lights off. Coking a lime on your chest. Wrapping my legs around your neck. I got unlimited time on my plan. Trying to call you my man. Yeah.
Okay, let's start off over here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to open up the lead vocal. Let's make sure that we're in the attack section. And now, if we head over to the attack section over here, and we scroll down, we have some different grid options. So none is obviously none, but still worth being said that we could click, hold, and drag any one of these SmartAttack points if we wanted to make manual adjustments. But let's explore some of the different ways in which we can work. So if we start off over here, let's take a look at working with a grid mode that would be based on a bar beat boundary. So notice that as I indicated the bar beats there, they've kind of locked into place and our session is matching in terms of our BPM. Now I can drag across these different SmartAttack points. And then I have two options. I have the option to align the selection to grid, which is a way that I prefer to work. Or if you wanted to align the whole entire performance, you could simply align all attacks to the grid. Let's make an adjustment here. And take note of what happened. We just quantized this vocal performance to a hard grid in terms of a bar beat boundary. Let's listen to that.
I got an unlimited time on my plan, trying to call you my man.
So that's one way that we can work. And you could go through the different sections where you think the vocal might need to be tightened up. This is really great if you have something that was a little bit loose. And instead of manual editing and trying to tweak and driving yourself crazy, you can just make a selection across those SmartAttack points and you can hard quantize them to a bar beat boundary. Let's undo this for a moment. I want to explore another different workflow approach, and that would be borrowing the groove from some sort of percussive element. So temporarily, I'm going to choose the stem lights off instrumental, which I've already imported into RePitch. And this is essentially the percussive stem. So if we head over to the stem over here, notice that there's different SmartAttack points that have been detected for the transients of this actual percussion stem over here. So let's head back to the lead vocal. Now this time, in terms of our quantizing, instead of choosing the option to use bar beat, what I'm actually going to do is pin the stem lights off instrumental, which is a percussive stem. And then the minute I pin that as a reference, you can see that that's been superimposed so we can see the timing variations. Now, in terms of the grid, I'm now going to choose the drum stem, which I have over here. So now this is based upon the transient detection that has been done. Now, we can see our vocal is overlaid behind here. So what I can do now is let's play this and we'll listen to the two of these against each other.
Wrapping my legs around your neck.
And also, let's make sure we're just isolating the lead vocal and the actual instrumental stem.
Wrapping my legs around your neck. I got unlimited time on my plan. Trying to call you my man.
Okay, what I'm going to do here is with the lead vocal selected and the stem pinned as a reference, I've chosen that as the grid mode. I'm going to change the mode from vocal to percussion because we want the actual transient detection to be based on a percussive algorithm. Now what I'm going to do is, keep in mind, I'm still on the lead vocal here. I'm going to make a selection across these different SmartAttack points. And now I'm going to choose the option to align the selection to grid. Let's take a listen now.
Wrapping my legs around your neck. I got unlimited time on my plan. Trying to call you my man. Yeah, you're a little wavy. You're talking all sorts of things like kids are.
Okay, maybe I want to do an adjustment here as well. So we'll align this selection to grid.
You're talking all sorts of things like kids or rings, but for now I know what's next.
Okay, so we can be selective and we can choose these different areas. We can go through this whole entire performance and we can choose to align these different sections.
Finish, you're the tastiest I've had.
So the idea here is that we're using a percussive reference track. We're extracting the groove. We're using the percussion mode, and then we're aligning selectively. Not the whole entire thing, but we are selectively choosing sections when we listen to them that it sounds a little bit off. Now, I happen to also have an instrumental in here, so temporarily, let's take this out of solo, and let's bring in the main instrumental track, and we'll bring that in, and let's take a listen to some of those sections. So if we scroll over here, we can kind of navigate to these different sections where we have the yellow indication that we've done something. So this is a really powerful tool because if you have different sections which just aren't sitting right in the pocket, we can isolate a percussive element, give ourselves kind of like a clipboard, which we can use as a reference point, and then we can quantize our vocals. Okay, so now here's the other thing I want to talk about. If we take a look at this production, we have more than one vocal track over here. Now that we've done the work to the lead vocal, and we're happy with the timing, all I want to do is borrow that timing from the lead vocal and any different section across the board, I want to apply that to all of these tracks. So let's explore doing that for a moment. I'm going to bring back in my drums. Let's actually take these out of solo. And now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to double click to open up the editor. We're going to go to the attack mode in each one of these tracks. Let's extend our zoom so we're looking at pretty much the full range of everything. If I scroll through any one of these multi-tracks that are available, I have the ability to change the track that I'm on, and I don't have to worry about which clip or which event or anything is selected. So in each of these tracks, all of these harmonies, the lead vocal's been pinned as a reference. What I'm going to do in this case is make sure that I'm going to go to my grid and I'm going to choose the lead vox. And in terms of the mode, I want this to be vocal. And in this case, instead of choosing selectively, which you could do if you wanted to, I'm just going to align all attacks to grid. And it was kind of hard to see that. If you take note, I'm going to click undo, keep your eye on this section over here. Undo and redo. You can see things are just subtly shifting. So let's just scroll through down on every single one of these. I'm going to align all the different sections to the track. We'll go to this one, we'll align, and then we'll go to this harmony, and we will align. And now, essentially, I've just moved through, and I've adjusted the timing of my lead vocal. I've quantized it to the groove in certain areas, and then any one of these harmony tracks that were set to follow, I've just brought that in. So let's take a listen to the final result of everything. Okay, so perfect. We're able to make any decisions that we want with respect to the lead vocal's timing. We can borrow from the actual extracted groove from our drums or our percussion loop. We can apply that in different sections, make any manual adjustments, and then we have the ability to use the SmartAttack points on each track, and we can align the full entire duration of each one of these harmonies. And even though there's gaps and silence in between here, it's still doing all the work, and it's aligning and changing that. Let's take one moment actually to talk about VocALign really quickly, because this is something similar that we can do with VocALign. And the benefit with using VocALign is really when you need to adjust the timing and pitch, and you need to have control over how much you want to align the timing. The one thing to take note of with this is pretty much like a 100% quantization, but in my experience, it works really, really well. There's a couple different unique ways that you can use it as we've explored in this video. So I hope that gives you a good idea as to what we can do with the different SmartAttack points and the different groove alignment options in RePitch. I'm Marcus Huyskens, and we'll catch you in the next video. Cheers.